Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new, hi, I'm Makeup Wake Up Croatia, also known as Rina, and this is a channel where I talk about beauty, lifestyle and fashion. Today I will be doing my first English video, so English spoken video, so I have to beg you for patience because I know my accent is a bit rough and I hope with time it will only get better. So today's video is empties videos, and with that we can also call it top or flop. I think it's a catchy name. And while I talk about my empties, I will tell you, did I like them, did I not? And I see this as the best way to do reviews. So I believe that you have to use up product to tell your judgment about it. You can tell very bad critiques only about products that really break you out or cause you major reaction. Otherwise, I think it takes time, and I think this is the most honest way to make a review about some products, so let's begin. So, in no particular order, this is my first empty in this bag over here, which is full of empties. So, this is Dove Deeply Nourishing Shower Gel. It is in classic scent. It has very powdery scent. This is by no means an extraordinary revolutionary product, but it smells really nice. It does leave your skin feeling pretty nice, and it does the job. It cleans you out, it's very cheap, and this is my favorite drugstore shower gel. So the next product I'm taking off my empties bag is this Schwarzkopf Gliss Hair Repair Shampoo Supreme Length. I hate the lengthy titles of these shampoos. I hated this. I couldn't wait to make it go empty. It is very ordinary. It is so basic, and not because it is drugstore, because there are a lot of really nice drugstore shampoos, but this one, even if it does contain SLSs, it doesn't lather very much. It smells pretty okay, but the smell doesn't linger in your hair, and it takes a great amount of the shampoo to actually clean your hair. It didn't do anything for it. I bought this when I still had my long hair, but I didn't see any shine, I didn't see any less oiliness in my hair, I didn't see any repair, so this is really trash. So this is a very basic soft cleansing foam, so it does foam. I took it because it was very affordable, and it has Manuka honey extract. Manuka honey is very good for inflammations, and if you have acne prone skin, it is also known to do wonders for your skin. However, this didn't do anything. It did clean my face, but it didn't do anything spectacular. I much prefer my previous Aphrodita cleansing gel, and it is around the same price point. So, nope. So we have a balancing mask from Jeux de Mur. It is a South Korean brand. It has a lot of good ingredients for all skin types. It is mainly for nourishing your skin and moisturizing it. I really did like this mask, but I preferred the previous mask in my previous empties with blueberry extract. So it was good, but it wasn't revolutionary. So this is a very interesting empty. It is Elizabeth Arden Green Tea Honey Drops Body Cream. It is a long title. This is a cream. When I started using it, I was impressed with it. It is so strongly perfumed that by the time I was using it, it was even a little too perfumey for me, because in my body lotions, I like very warm, seductive scents, or natural but sweet scents. This is This is very artificial, if you know what I mean. And I don't mind it in my perfumes, but this was very strong. However, it did moisturize my skin very well. And the perfume really lingers a long time. So I would like to try the honey one from Elizabeth Arden, just because I think that scent will probably suit me better. But the formula is great and I appreciate it. This is a pricey product, but you have a decent amount and it lasts you a long time. So this is an empty I had for a long time. It is a L'Occitane ultra gentle soap for the face. It is only meant for the face. It has 7% of shea butter. This for face didn't do much, but this is an excellent brush cleaner and beauty sponge cleanser. This lasted me for ages, and regarding the price, I think it is worth for how good of a brush cleanser it is. So I would recommend this as a brush cleanser, but not necessarily for the face. So this is a product I had for a very long time. This is La Roche. This is super activated firming oil with pink berries. This is for dimpled skin and smoothing effect. It is from the brand called Melvita. This is great smoothing. I didn't see much difference regarding my cellulite, but I noticed difference with smoothness and firmness of my skin. So I would recommend it for someone who doesn't have very visible cellulite, or you don't see that as a problem, but you want to firm your skin. This is great for that. I recommend using these kinds of products if you're active, if you are walking a lot, or you're in some kind of training, because on its own it won't do much, but with some physical activity I think this will be great. I have to emphasize that anti-cellulite or firming oils or gels are always a lot more efficient with some kind of activity, because they can't do a lot on their own. Yes, that is my experience. But this isn't a bad oil. It is pricey though. I won't throw this because I think I would break it. This is Instant Anti-Age Maybelline Eraser Concealer. I have spent it. It lasted me, of all my concealers, the shortest. This doesn't go a long way. And I have a bit of a rant regarding concealers, and I would appreciate if you can put down in comments some good concealer, because I haven't tried a concealer in my life which I'm completely satisfied with, because I have very dark circles, and not only that, but the majority of them emphasize my texture. From high-end concealers, I really haven't tried any, because it is very hard for me to pay an amount which is almost as equal or sometimes bigger than high-end foundation. But if you have some recommendation, I will really take it, because I'm willing to maybe soon step out in the high-end zone regarding concealers, because the drugstore ones aren't doing it for me. This is nice formula, but on me it doesn't last. If I put it anywhere other than my under eyes, it melts away. No matter how much I powder it, it can't be worn on its own. I have to combine it with foundation. So bye bye Maybelline. So this is a Tony Moly Painting Therapy Pack SOS Care. This is for all skin types. This is a pink clay face mask. I prefer my Tony Moly that black pack face mask. It cleanses my skin more, but I think this is a decent face mask and it does suit my face. That other one maybe softens it more, but this one suits it. So if you don't have very complicated skin and you just want something to maybe suit your skin, this may be a good one after you have a sunburn. I would recommend this. It is a decent face mask and Tony Moly has some great products and they're super cute. So what would be my empties or favorites video if I don't have some L'Occitane product? This is a 20% shea butter dry skin hand cream. This is the best hand cream for dry skin that I have ever tried. This bad boy lasted me for ages. When I tell you ages, I mean it. I mean ages. And I would definitely recommend you picking this up if you have a problem with texture on your hands. It smells great, it soaks in fast, and it is an overall phenomenal product. So next concealer is again Maybelline. This one is Superstay Full Coverage Under Eye Concealer in color Fair, because I'm fair. This one I grabbed on recommendation of Tati because I trust her reviews, and out of all drugstore concealers I have to say this is the best, but it isn't good for me. It is basic. The main point is all of these concealers are basic, and in this one as well as Tati said, you have a really harsh time getting the product to stick on this little wand. I don't know, is it because of the tube, but the payoff is really bad and you have to lather it on. But it is decent concealer, and if you don't have very problematic under eye area, I think it would suit you. But for me, sadly, it doesn't do it. I need something stronger. So sorry Maybelline, but this is the best for me. Oh, I'm so excited to tell you about this product. It is Evelyn Cosmetics Expert C 12% active vitamin C. It is a serum and it is meant to be used only at night because I believe because of how strong it is. This is a great, I don't think you will find a more affordable vitamin C serum, and I noticed the difference. It took me around 2 months, about how long this lasted me, but my skin really was evened out, my scars are less visible, and it smells like oranges. I don't know, is it artificial scent or is this vitamin C really from some citric fruit, but it didn't break me out. It wasn't harsh, it wasn't like burning. I didn't feel the unpleasant commotion on my face. This is so dirt cheap, and I would recommend if you are looking for an overnight serum with vitamin C, try Evelyn Cosmetics if you can find it. I am so pleased with this product. Best serum with vitamin C I have ever tried. So I will just toss it this lightly because it is glass. Okay, it fell on me. Next. So in the last half of year, I started using deodorants which aren't antiperspirants. That means they don't have aluminium salts, because I had a very common itching sensation under my armpits, and I heard a lot of bad things about aluminium salts, because basically that means that salts tighten or close your pores, which is not healthy because we are meant to sweat. So this deodorant is by Alverde, which is DM's kind of a brand in its household. This is a men's deo roll-on. It smells very earthy, but not in a bad way, and the scent doesn't linger a lot. You have to get used on the wetness of it, but let me tell you, this doesn't break, so I don't scent myself throughout the day. I don't smell, and I'm a sweater. I sweat like a man. I really do. I think I got that from my father. And while my mother and brother don't sweat at all, my father and I sweat while we sleep. So I think this is the best deodorant I have ever tried. And at this moment, I'm empty of this, so I'm using another antiperspirant, because at that time when I was buying the deodorant, I wasn't able to find something like that. But I will repurchase this, and I will repurchase it a million times. This is the best deodorant, which is natural, in drugstore or high-end category. This is best, period. So if you're into natural deodorants, this one is what I recommend very, very greatly. Another concealer. This is NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop. It is in the shade... I don't know in which... Vanilla. So it looks full, but it is empty. I almost can't get anything on the wand. This is also a concealer. I had my high hopes up and I was very, very let down. If I use it anywhere other than my under eyes, it melts. And my under eyes are looking kind of crepey when I'm using this. So it is okay. But for complicated under eyes like mine, I wouldn't recommend it. So by NYX, I just almost kill myself with concealer. Next. So this is a very sad empty. This is Missoni Eau de Parfum. This was one of my favorite perfumes. It smells perfect, and there isn't any left. It has a beautiful packaging, but the scent is even more beautiful. If you like summery scents, powerful but not too overpowering, I would recommend this perfume, because it is wonderful and it lasts. It really, really lasts. For the last thing, last empty is 8-in-1 Miracle Serum by Dirty Works. I got this on sale and I used it as a day serum. This is mostly hyaluronic acid serum with some other things. It actually wasn't bad. I wouldn't repurchase it, because I think for my skin type, there may be some more intense and better day serums. But this is very basic but very effective serum for somebody who doesn't have very complicated skin. And even my skin, which is very, very demanding, loved this serum. In a way, it make my skin soft, and it gave me that moisture but not greasiness, and it lasted a long time. And for how really affordable it is for the amount you get, I would really, really recommend it to someone who doesn't have very complicated skin. Bye bye. So I hope you like these empty videos and my English speaking video. I hope I will get better with my pronunciation of words. I'm trying to speak slower and lower so you can understand what I'm trying to say, and that it is easier for me to say what I think, because in my mind I speak English like Emma Watson, but my tongue and teeth and mouth aren't accustomed to speaking English as much as listening to it. I hope you're staying safe, and I hope you enjoyed in this little video. Until next time, enjoy your week, wash your hands, and I'll see you. Bye!